with crispy kale, forage watercress, and miner's lettuce. So the cracker, I think, is used, it's designed as, I like to plate things up as I go. So we have the asparagus dish here. So towards, on the bottom, we have an almond milk and asparagus soup. There's some pickled kohlrabi, which is radish-like vegetable, if you're unfamiliar. Lovely Armstrong asparagus stems. House-made chorizo, made in-house, and there's a couple of quail's eggs. Flaked almonds on top, and also edible pansies. The olives here, we have three kinds. We have Castel Vetrano, which are the greens.
Right.
The kind of wrinkly ones here are dried Moroccan, and then, sorry, my bad, the green. Albuquerque, the dried Moroccan are the wrinkly ones, and Castel Vetrano, they're the burgundy. There's a lovely mix of mustard leaf on top, and they're baked in our canola oil, and there's some pickled Rainier cherries through there as well. And everything has pits in it, so just watch out for that.
Yeah.
And then we have our Kennebec potato chips here, so topped with Asiago cheese and a lovely house-made garlic.
Cool.
A mouthful there, sorry for starting.
Oh, that's fantastic. So what are these?
Rosemary rice burgers. So basically, they get rice, and they do the ratio of rice to water. Bring it to the boil so all the starch is gone.
Right.
And then once that's done, they put in some lovely charred ash and rosemary and kind of puree it, and then they rehydrate it, and that's what's going to give it that crispness and kind of like crunchiness. It reminds me of like a prawn cracker. We have Chinese food. Yeah, it's a lovely, lovely lunch, lovely crunch in there.
No, thank you.
You're very welcome.
Yeah.
I know they sent, I did think they were going to bring it out in two courses.
Yeah.
So if you want, I can bring the other wines out as well. Or
sure. As long as we know what to have with what.
Yeah, so I'd recommend.